Welcome to another vlog episode of Die by the Blade development team. I know you have been waiting for quite some time, but we have been really working hard on various things, and I want to show you at least a glimpse of what we have been working on these past few weeks and what our future plans are. One of the most complicated features of fighting games is online multiplayer feature, and we have spent best part of the year working on multiplayer systems, the backend, the replication, the server architecture, various systems and actually a combat system as well to work in tandem with online multiplayer. One other feature that we have promised in our Kickstarter campaign was tournament mode, in which you will be able to fight multiple players with a kind of tournament structure. We wanted to have that working in the multiplayer as well as couch local multiplayer. Another big feature of the game is single player campaign. We have basically three big stages where you can free roam and walk around and have fights as well. Again, it's a fighting game, so you still have some kind of arenas in the single player mode, but the amount of arenas will grow really substantially from what we have just shown, and we are excited to show you much more stuff later down the line. Since we were listening to your feedback and your opinions on the matter, we decided to create practice mode, which is a bit different from tutorial mode. In the practice mode, you will be able to turn AI on and off. You will be able to see the collision boxes, you will be able to see traces of the weapons, you will be able to basically measure the distance between the characters, which is really important. Another big area of improvement was UI. One of the features that we needed to have was to show the UI elements for combos. We also improved on in-game UI. We have added indicators for the input buffers. We added energy indicators so that you can see what's the energy of your opponent, and know where to strike, when to strike, basically to bring visual clarity to our gameplay systems. Last but not least, we also moved to a new version of Unreal Engine 4.27.2. It improved stability of the game, it improved visuals in our trailers, in some screenshots, the characters themselves looked a bit plasticky. So now we are basically redoing some elements of the characters, improving their skin, improving their hair, their facial features, so that the characters actually look much nicer. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I wish you happy holidays and even happier new year. We will be back next year with new updates and with big announcements very soon in 2022. See you later. Thanks for watching again. Bye.